Hello guys, this is Anne Mole from Paris and Baz Real Estate and Finance. Can you believe it is only 9 weeks until Christmas? So that means for those of you that are looking at moving into your new home by Christmas, there's only 2 weeks left to be able to find a property, sign the contract, and go into that 6 week period for settlement. So time is running out fast. What we're going to do for the next 5 days, we're going to be coming to you live every single day to talk about in detail what are the 5 things that you need to do now in order to move into your new home by Christmas. So naturally, there's those that are first home buyers and those that have existing property. So we'll be touching on both of those. The first thing that what we're going to be talking in more detail today is about what exactly you're looking for and how do you actually find it. So as you all know, first of all, we're nearly getting to the end of 2020. The pandemic is nearly over. And I know that a lot of you have realized the shortcomings of the property that you are currently living in, which is what is instigating the reason for the move. So the first step is to be able to have top three things that are important to you, which is the motivation for your move. For a lot of you at this point in time, it is about the school catchment, for example. So next year, enrolling the kids into the right school, what are the schools that you're looking at, whether the current property that you're living in is not as sunlit as you want it to be, it doesn't have a office or a home study or that additional bedroom to be able to use as a space for you to work from home. So those are some of the motivations that we are looking at from those that are buying currently, of upgrading to from where they are right now. And naturally, for those that are first home buyers, it is taking advantage of a lot of the incentives that the government has brought up. So lots of opportunity for you to be able to make those decisions. So the first step is the top three things that you're looking for. The second thing, the fact that once you know exactly what you're after, the bedrooms, bathrooms, and the suburb, and the school catchment, and the types of features of the property, how to actually find it is definitely important. A lot of those that may not be familiar with some of the features of the property portals where you're normally finding properties, for the likes of realestate.com.au and domain.com.au. Did you know on realestate.com.au you can actually search by feature? So if you are looking for a property with swimming pool, with ducted air conditioning, or with a study, a lot of those features are implemented and inserted into the listings from us as agents in the back end, which means at the front end you will be able to search for those individual features. So that's definitely a key tip there for realestate.com.au. Secondly, the likes of Domain have properties that are within a particular school catchment. You can search by the school catchment also. So it's very good to be able to understand how you can actually find that property. Hello to everyone that's coming on. How you can actually find that property on the portals when you've established what exactly the type of property that you're looking for and that motivation for you to make the move. Now, the second part that we're going to be talking to you about tomorrow is going to be about the whole craze about the off-market listings. I'm sure a lot of you would be aware when you are currently in the market going out looking for properties, good properties are selling within the first open home. So there's a number of steps that you want to be able to do prior to be able to, on the day of your inspecting the property, you've got everything lined up, ready to go, your ducks lined up, ready to go in order to make that offer on that day, because good properties are selling fast. And there is also news that next month, in the month of November, there's talks about the interest rates being, the cash rate, official cash rate being cut as well. So a lot of activity that is stimulating demand, which means a lot of buyers that are going to individual properties, there is that one successful buyer that ends up putting that offer in once they've got everything done up beforehand and being able to purchase the property. Hello Vinod, you've got a question. Will there be any stats on suburb pricing? More than happy to share stats. Please do feel free to reach out on a private message as well. Or if you want to type some suburbs here, I'll be happy to come back to you with the stats on what exactly the trends are in the different suburbs. Now, naturally, being a independent agency, we do have a good cross-section of a number of suburbs because we do cover the likes of Oran Park, the likes of Austral, even though we're based in the Hills District, but we're able to help a lot of our clients throughout Sydney. So we do have a good cross-section of what is happening in different suburbs. So if there's anything particular that you're wanting information on, please let me know. I'll be happy to provide you some key stats on what is happening within that suburb. So talking about in the fact that there is a lot of demand, which means good properties are selling fast, naturally the next step to be able to do from there is to be able to get on the off-market database. So we're going to be talking about that in more detail. So do tune in again tomorrow. We'll be talking about that, about how do you actually be the first one to know when the property is going to go on the market, and what, from our agent perspective, we're actually utilizing this system where all we've got is a suburb. We've got the address. We've got the contract of sale ready to go. So we're saying this particular property is coming on the market in the next 2 weeks' time or a week time. Anyone that's currently interested prior, get in touch with us. Let's show you privately so you can avoid that congestion at open homes, which normally about 30 to 40 families are going through at a time. So stay tuned. I'll come back to you tomorrow and then every single day for this week with things that you need to be able to do to be able to move into your next home by Christmas. Thank you for tuning in. We'll see you guys. See you tomorrow.